Hi and good morning from Disney's Polynesian Village Resort. Today is going to be an exciting day. We are heading to Animal Kingdom to have a fun time over there. Got some pretty cool fast passes. We had a really, really nice stay here last night. We're here for a few more days yet to come. But let's get to Animal Kingdom. And here we are, we made it to Animal Kingdom. We got the whole family here. We got Mama, we got Dennis, and then we got Dad right up there. Hi guys.
Hi.
So we are heading to Dinosaur. Yes, it is. It is like 105 degrees. Would you believe that?
That's why I got my cool wrap on, dude.
We're gonna have to duck into some shows or restaurants or gift stores today because it's so hot. But our first stop is Dinosaur for a fast pass.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
One of my favorite.
There's barely a cloud in the sky right now. It is so hot. And Animal Kingdom's already arguably the hottest Walt Disney World theme park. So it's gonna be kind of a day today, but we got the whole group today. And I'm pretty excited. It's gonna be nice to have everybody together. So this is Hakuna Matata time. There's Baloo right there. I think, there's Timon and Turk. There's Rafiki over there. And even Kevin way back there in the back. There's Kevin. This is awesome. It's the first time I've gotten to see Kevin over here. She's adorable. Little wings and everything. All right, heading into Dinoland. They're playing All-Star right now, which is hilarious. Also, check this out. I just found this on the ground. This is one game credit for Dinorama. So we could totally use this over here and maybe play a game and win a little prize. That's the Triceratops spin, and we're heading back over here towards Dinosaur. I'm trying to remember the last time that I did this. I think it's been kind of a minute too. And we made it over to Dinosaur. We were just walking by a cast member and he saw our birthday buttons right here. And he gave us a free cookie, myself and my dad, because we're both wearing birthday buttons. All right, we are inside Dinosaur. It is actually pretty busy in here comparatively to how it normally is. We're still kind of like tailing off the end of Memorial Day, so that could still kind of be those crowds, but it's not that bad, especially when you got a fast pass, am I right?
Hello there. Welcome to our little trans-dimensional joyride, folks. I'm Dr. Seeker, your friendly controller, and a heck of a paleontologist, if I do say so myself.
All right, hopefully we do Dr. Seeker proud, and we go get our dino. Right, Dennis?
Woo!
Let's go rescue a dino.
This is Seeker. Listen up. We've got to get him, grab the iguanodon, and get him.
That was a lot of fun, and I know that it's been a long time since I've ridden this because I haven't gotten to say hello to my little friend over here. There he is. Hey buddy, I'm sorry it's been so long since I've been over here. Hope you're doing good. So Dinosaur is right back there, and we just met Pluto right here on our way out of the exit of Dinosaur because he had a very short line. Now we're heading inside here, and I think we're actually gonna go use this right here that I found on the ground, or I'm gonna give it to Dennis and maybe he can use it. The ceiling in this gift store though is one of the most detailed and intricate buildings I think that I've ever seen here at Animal Kingdom. Animal Kingdom does such an incredible job of doing this, but in here specifically, it is just so ridiculously detailed. All right, so we're in the Dinorama area, and I'm gonna give this ticket to Dennis. He's gonna decide which game he wants to play. There's this game over here. There's another one over there. There's a basketball game right over here. There's a little racing game over there. Looks like there's a throwing game. All right, Dennis is playing the basketball game. He's gotta be nice and gentle with this. Nice and gentle, Dennis. You can do it. Oh no! An extra shot. Oh no!
So, in my defense, I'm used to a much taller hoop, about 9 feet. I usually jump. And I'm too strong now, so I kept overthrowing it.
Dennis is a climber, so he's equating his loss to his swole forearms.
Well, you know, I just kind of like flicked it and then went.
I wanted that teeny tiny little dino plush, Dennis, and you broke my heart. So now we're heading over to Pandora to ride what, Dennis? Find a message! Cutting back across the Tree of Life, heading into Pandora. Man, it is just still so hot. There's a couple of clouds in the sky, but nowhere near where I need them to be, which is right in front of the sun. And we made it to beautiful Pandora. We're heading straight over to Flight of Passage right now because we're right in the middle of our return time window. And while we were walking over here, I got a lunch reservation for Yak and Yeti. Yes, I love Yak and Yeti. It has been a minute since I've been able to ride Flight of Passage, especially getting to Fast Pass it. So today's an awesome, awesome day. And we have some fun plans tonight too for dinner. I'll show you those in just a second once those are solidified. Wow, look at this view. It never ever gets old. The only thing about the Fast Pass line is that you bypass everything that's really awesome in the standby line, so you don't get to see it. But that's okay because you get to get on so expedited, and it is so worth it because this ride is so much fun. Right, Mom?
Absolutely. Love it.
Hi, and welcome to the Avatar program. Soon, you're going to have a chance to undertake an amazing Navi rite of passage. Riding on the back of a banshee by being genetically matched and linked to an avatar.
For your safety, throughout this entire experience, remain seated. Lean forward, holding onto the hand grips, and supervise your children.
So it's interesting because we sat in the bottom far right side of the theater and it was still a great experience comparatively to Soarin'. If you sit in the bottom right, everything's curved and stuff. You have to kind of like do this. Nope, it was awesome.
I'm trying to complete my Infinity Gauntlet of sitting in every single possible spot on Flight of Passage.
Flight of Passage? You've only ridden it like, what, three times?
Yeah, but I need to sit in what, all nine corners?
Thank you, Roy.
Did you have fun?
That is our favorite ride.
Really?
Dinosaur. And then we call it the Banshee ride. That's not the name of it, but
Flight of Passage.
Flight of Passage.
And then Dennis had a good point. I do actually agree with that. I want to be able to ride in the top, middle, and bottom, and then the left, middle, and then right side. So I guess it is kind of like nine different spots you could experience it.
Oh, I never remember what it's like time to time, but.
All right, so we just came down the mountain over there after doing Flight of Passage, and we're checking out the mech demonstration over here, which is really, really, really cool.
All right, I'm having some control issues here. I'm going to go back for a second pass. That's what I'm going to do. Woo! There we go. Nothing like launching off the line at maximum velocity. I understand the most of you travelers have just a blur, but that's about to change.
All right, so we're heading out of Pandora right now, and I guess through this bypass area, then over to Africa for some lunch at Yak and Yeti. Every time I take this path, I think about how I waited right over here the first time I ever rode Flight of Passage. The line was all the way back here. We're passing by the Lion King, and there's some sort of construction going on right back there. Kinda wonder what that's for, but we're heading through Africa and then over there for Yak and Yeti. I think, which is probably technically in Asia. We're passing right by the Up a Great Bird Adventure Theater because Yak and Yeti is right here. We're about 5 minutes early, actually, so we timed that pretty well. So we're inside Yak and Yeti right now. We have the menus here. Dennis and I may split this sake right here, but as far as what we're getting to eat, I think I'm gonna get this Kobe beef burger right here. I think we're gonna split this firecracker shrimp as well. The ahi tuna nachos looks really good. Dennis, I think, is gonna get this dim sum basket. This place is just so good and so portable for really whatever you want to get here. It's so awesome. Firecracker shrimp just came out and we're all divvying up. Ah!
Thank you.
We're all divvying up the portions.
Ooh, that's pretty spicy.
Is it? Oh no.
So the food just got here. Dennis and my dad got the dim sum baskets. What did you get there, Mom?
This is a shrimp lo mein.
Ooh, and then this is my Kobe beef burger with some fries. Look at that. That is awesome. So as a reference, we just sat right there at that corner table. This is kind of like the main room in here. We've sat right there before, and then with Brennan, once I sat upstairs. Was it good, dude? All right, now we're heading back outside and into the hot, hot sun. Man, that was just so good. So now the plan is to go over here to Cali River Rapids because we were going to ride Expedition Everest, but it actually went down. So we got a redemption fast pass for that, and I think we're gonna use it over here at Cali River Rapids. Wow, so this is a 130 minute wait for Cali River Rapids. Well, this is a little bit awkward. This is the backed up line for fast pass. This may not be good. It's a very hot day today. So this is kind of intense. This may be everybody that also had an Everest fast pass that decided to use it here. Yikes, everybody's in the fast pass line. You can kind of see the rafts right down there going by. And we are still waiting in this incredibly long fast pass line. I guess everybody wants to get a little relief from the heat today. All right, we just caught up with the standby line and I wanted to show off my favorite guy in this queue right there with his goofy looking teeth in his face. We're moving slowly, but we are moving. All right, that didn't take really that long. It was about 20, maybe 25 minutes, but we are about to load onto our boat and everybody coming off kind of looks relatively wet. Are you excited, guys?
I don't want to go backwards.
Well, that may be the case. We're going up the first ramp right now. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Woo! Going over the first little drop here. Oh no, a geyser. All right, that geyser got us pretty good. Mom got drenched over there. And then Dennis got pretty wet too. Sorry, Dennis.
It's fine.
This is the more scenic part of the experience here. Going by, ow! Going by this deforestation scene. Right behind us, then with Everest right back there in the background. But this is the first big drop over here, so I'm definitely putting the camera away right now. Woo! We survived for the most part. I think Mom and Dad got it the worst over there. Pretty much just wet kind of from the waist down. Dennis is doing pretty good, right, Dennis? Oh, your back's pretty bad, right? But that was it. That was a very, very quick ride, but very refreshing. That was a lot of fun. That was actually Dennis's idea. Did you have fun, Dennis?
All my ideas are good ideas.
Of course. Did you guys have fun?
I got soaked. My whole left side is drenched.
Mm-hmm. I just kind of got my shorts here and a little bit of my shoes. Dennis's back is pretty wet.
That's the perfect amount.
Yeah.
A little cooled off now.
Dad's not that wet. That's good. This is what really got us at the end here. You can press this button and you can make the elephants squirt the people in the rafts. And right now there's kind of like a backup, so if you're sitting there, you're gonna get drenched. So from what I can tell, Everest is back open right now, but we're actually not going to Everest, we're going to another roller coaster over in Dinoland. What's that, Dennis?
It's another Dennis idea. It's the primeval world!
Nice.
Spin the camera.
Daddy!
No, like, this way.
Why?
It's primeval world.
Like this?
Yeah.
No! Like, woo! All right, we are back in Dinoland, heading straight over here to Primeval World. I don't know what Dennis was talking about, wanted me to do this, or... What did you want me to do again? Oh, you wanted me to do like this, right?
Yeah!
Okay, well, that was just probably nauseating for the people watching this. This is gonna be fun. Hey, Dennis. Dennis is checking himself out of the mirror, and then there's Mom and Dad. I don't know if they've ever done this before. All right, here we go! You excited, Mama? She's gonna be on the edge. Dennis is next to me, and then Dad's right over here.
We should have been
here.
Here we go.
Here we go. We're going back in time. Whoa.
Hold on, babe.
Whoa.
Good.
Here we go. The first drop. The end is near.
I got you.
I sure hope so.
Whoa!
You having fun?
Yeah.
Oh, here we go, we're spinning!
Whoa! I don't like this ride all.
There's Roy!
Ah!
It's not even over.
Hold on!
Take your camera back.
Hold on! Whoa!
So,
just for good measure, we're getting three more good whiplash.
What's the consensus?
It hurts your shoulders and your hips.
And your hips?
Yep, but it's fun.
What'd you think, Dad?
That's too jerky for me, man. That's a jerky, bumpy ride.
That was scary.
So maybe I am by myself in this, but I actually like Primeval World. I like how it's kind of aggressive and jerks you around. It's all over the place. I don't know. I enjoy it sometimes, not all the time. So for our next activity, we're not going too far. We're just heading right across the parking lot to Triceratops Spin. There's Dad right down there. He decided to sit this one out.
Yay!
Because Primeval World was a little bit intense.
Fire,
Mama. Hey, Mama, take us up.
Keep going.
There we
Keep
go. Going. Now, Dennis and I are in charge of the front and the backward motion. So now we're leaning back. Woo! Yeah, now tilt this forward. There we go. What a blast! So I got one more fast pass for the evening for Navi River Journey. That one's gonna be around like 9 o'clock. And then I don't think I said this yet, I got us a dinner reservation. Ooh, it's kinda dark. Oh, there we go. I got a dinner reservation at Tusker House. Woo! Yay, Tusker House! It's character dining, which I'm excited about, so we'll be there hopefully in a few hours. Wanted to show off Dinoland real quick. There's the dance party going on over there. There's Primeval World. And I think everybody is coming down now. Yay!
Oh, the bubbles are here. You know what that means?
It's a party!
No, this party's officially popping. That's what it means.
Not you.
Because the bubbles.
Oh. All right, y'all go dance. There you go.
Oh, we got ourselves a packed dance floor.
It's snowing. It's 105 degrees and it's snowing out here. Now there's some bubbles. There's Chip and Dale over there and Pluto. Woo! So Hakuna Matata time is still going on. We're here, I think, for about maybe 5 to 10 more minutes. So that's really cool. There's Baloo right there. And there's Simone who just did what's that called? A limbo. Duh. So now next we're gonna head over here to do It's Tough to Be a Bug. And we actually may also do the Tree of Life Gardens, like a little like walkthrough area over here. And we're doing it. We're about to do Tough to Be a Bug. Are you excited for this, Dennis? That you're exhilarated, I can tell. You always have told me you're like, that's my favorite ride at any Disney park. Tough to Be a Bug, right there. Right now we are amongst the roots and the dirt of the Tree of Life. The theming of this ride, the ride itself may not be the best, but the theming of this ride is just immaculate, honestly. Hi, Mom. So now we are underneath the Tree of Life to see, well, if it'll focus, this right here. It's Tough to Be a Bug. All right, we are all done with It's Tough to Be a Bug, and that was as terrifying as it always is. With the Black Widow spiders and the effects and Hopper and everything. So we just looped around back to the entrance of Tough to Be a Bug to do the Tree of Life Garden Trail walk. I think this recently reopened after kind of being under a refurbishment, so it's gonna be kind of cool to check it out. This is a very quaint little trail that's adjacent to the It's Tough to Be a Bug Q trail. And it's just so beautiful over here. Not a lot of people know about this trail. You get to go right up underneath the Tree of Life, right there. Also, this is kind of interesting. It looks like this patch of, it's not really wood, but it looks like it's new comparatively to something like this over here. Doesn't that look kind of new? And after walking through the tunnel and past the waterfall, you come out on this side here on the other side of the Tree of Life. And unlike last time where there was a giant wall over there, it's now nice and open. Not really sure why there was a wall here in the first place, because there's really not much left of a trail over here, because right there is Starbucks. And for the most part, there was the Tree of Life Gardens. Now I think we actually are going to Starbucks to grab a little refresher, because it's just so hot today, and it's been so dehydrating. We need a little help.
I think I pointed at Pizza Fari, but we're going over here to Starbucks for our refresher. And then after this, I think we can go over to Festival of the Lion King. I think then after that is Tusker House, and then maybe Navi River Journey.
So we just got out of Starbucks, and what was really cool is on the way in, a couple cast members saw that it was my birthday and my dad's birthday, and they came over and they gave us this pastry right here. It did have two ears, but Dennis got a little excited, and then my dad had the other ear, so it did look like a Mickey, but it's like a caramel vanilla drizzled pastry, I think. I haven't tried it yet. And then we all got some refreshers. Dennis got a strawberry, and then us three got the mango dragon fruit refresher.
Roy left me alone with the cinnamon roll for 5 minutes and didn't tell me not to eat it.
So I wanted to take a picture.
You didn't say so.
All right, so almost done with the refresher. Now we're heading into Africa, past Tusker House, over there to the Lion King Theater because we're gonna watch Festival of the Lion King. Whew! All right, we made it. We're about 20 minutes early, which is probably a good thing.
Thank you. It's getting we clear. And where do we meet ya? Just listen to teacher.
Just finished up with Festival of the Lion King. What'd you guys think?
Great.
That was our first time getting to sit where we sat, actually.
Yeah,
we sat at the warthog
cool.
section.
I didn't like being a warthog because I can't make a warthog noise very well.
Well, let me hear it. Now I gotta know.
I'm not sure what a draft.
That was pretty good.
But it's hard to do that loud. Everybody else is like, rah! We're like.
But other than that, the show was pretty, pretty cool to see from that close.
Oh, that was amazing. I loved it.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Did you like it, Dad?
Great.
Okay, good. and then Dennis liked it too. So now our next stop is actually right over here. Well, did you have an opinion?
It's my favorite show.
Really? Yeah. So now our next stop after Festival of the Lion King is going to be right over here, conveniently at Tusker House. All right, so we just got our text saying that our table was ready. And here we are going to Tusker House. Haven't been here in kind of a long time. I've only ever been here once before this. So there goes Mickey right back there. There's Daisy Duck right over there. We just met both of them. There's Goofy. And then way over there is Donald. There he goes, right around the corner. So we just met Mickey and Daisy. Right now we're just kind of hanging out at the table. The rest of the family went to go to the buffet back there to start getting some food. And I'm just kind of here holding down the fort. But it just happened really, really quick. I didn't film any of it because it was just like, oh, they came up and we got some cool pictures, and then they were on their way to meet some other people. So we just met Goofy. He's right back there in the back room. Back there, there's Mickey right there. Daisy's right over here. And Donald, I think, is coming right around the corner over here in just a second. But the rest of the family has food, which means it's my turn to head right into here and get some food. That's the dining room right back there. And the room that the buffet is in. It's really, really beautiful. This center area over here is where all the desserts are, and then surrounding all that is the actual food selections. So over here are various breads, and there's looks like some toppings, I guess, for those breads. Over here is the salad bar. And there's a little fruit bar right over here. Some beans over there. And these are the actual entrees, more or less, over here. I know I'm doing a very quick job of this, just kind of showing everything off, but I am hungry and I want to go ahead and get into the foods. There's some ham and cheese right down there. I think this is the kids' area over here because they have some mac and cheese and corn. And then over here are all the different meats, chickens and whatnot, plantains. Wow. And then over there they can actually cut you a slice of something. So Donald is way back there, which means he came to the table while we were getting food. But this is our, well, this is my first plate here, and everybody else has quite a spread of things that they thought looked pretty good. We can go back as many times as we want, but this is a pretty good place to start. So there's Daisy right there. There's good old Mickey Mouse. Way back there is Goofy. We've seen all them. They've come by a few times, but we are waiting on that guy right over there, Mr. Donald Duck. So we did get to meet Donald. He just came by, and right now they're just kind of hanging out, playing with some maracas. I think they're going to march around the dining room in just a second. What do you think? Fun, right? We're doing it, Dennis! Last time that I was here, we sat right over there. Oh, I'm off beat. Here we go. There it is. Hi. Woo! That was
awesome.
So that was incredibly awesome, but now I'm coming to get some dessert here, probably before I put it all away. They have some really good looking stuff here. Let's see what this is over here. That looks so good. Oh, I had this last time, I'm pretty sure, and it was incredible. All right, I'm definitely gonna get that. And some cookies over there. There's really nobody at the buffet right now. It's 9 o'clock, so I don't know how late Tusker House is open, but maybe they're gonna be putting everything away here pretty soon. And there it is, there's my bread pudding. I've got a little raspberry tart there, and then a caramel pecan chocolate muffin, it looks like. So we were actually the very last people inside Tusker House tonight. Also, what I didn't notice before is that there's actually another dining room right over here, but I don't think that anybody was in it, at least while we were here. It's a little bit smaller, but kind of makes sense, I guess, that there's a little bit more room than just that one over there. And here's the buffet, and now I think we are heading outside and then on to Pandora, actually, for another fast pass. So that was Tusker House right back there. We're passing right by the Festival of the Lion King yet again to head into Pandora, like I said, because I got us some River Journey Fast Passes. I think I said this earlier, but we're gonna go redeem them and then head out of the park. All right, and we made it back to Pandora. You can't really see it because camera can't do it justice, but look at this bioluminescence right here. This is just so beautiful. I love it. All right, we're heading over to Navi River Journey. So it's currently listed as a 55-minute wait for Navi River Journey, but it does not look like it. Yep, so there was absolutely zero wait for this, so didn't need a fast pass at all. So that was a little bit of a disappointment, not getting to see the animatronic shaman. I guess she's undergoing some maintenance right now, but it was still a little bit sad. Until next time, Pandora. I'll see you soon. Wow, we just missed getting sprayed by that. That would have been kind of unfortunate. We are heading out of Animal Kingdom now, back to the parking lot, and then back to the Polynesian.
All right, so we made it back to the Polynesian. Today was a very long day. We'd originally planned to maybe like go to the park and then come back around the middle hot part of the day, but we just kind of ended up staying there the whole day. We got a lot done today. We pretty much did all of Pandora. We rode everything that we wanted to except for Everest, but that kind of worked out because we got to go ride Cali River Rapids, which was a lot of fun. As for tomorrow, I don't really know what we're going to be doing tomorrow, but we're going to talk about it and come to a consensus. Maybe we'll have like a later day. Maybe we'll have like a really early day. I don't know, but I'm pretty excited for it. We're gonna have a lot of fun regardless. We had a lot of good food today. We met some characters, a lot of good rides. I don't know, today was a good day, but see you tomorrow. Have a good day. Goodbye.